And I would like to thank you all for taking time to be with us this morning. What we're going to cover on the, in this webinar is stated on this agenda. And we'll first give you a short introduction to Business Analyze and the Business Analyze Cloud solution. We will talk about increased predictability from combination of CRM and ERP data, and introducing the historic pipeline and what to benefit from this. And we think this is a hot topic because every business manager would like to have a clear view of how a month is going to end up even before it starts. And many of our customers say they do. So let's get into this. At the end of this webinar, we will have a short question and answer session and a short summary. And as we go along, in your GoToWebinar panel, which most of you, I guess, will have in the right corner, you have dialogues such as this. And just put in your questions as we go along and submit and send them to the staff, and we will answer them in this Q&A session at the end of the webinar. Also, if you think this box is too big and show, covers too much of your screen, just press the arrow pointing at the right, which I point at now, and it will, the dialog here will minimize, so we see the full screen. Because as we will see, I have a lot of details to show you going on. Okay. Two words about Business Analyze. We sell through a network of certified partners as well as directly. But most of you have bought Business Analyze for SuperOffice / SuperOffice Analyze, as most of you know it as, from one of our partners. And as of now, we have about 400 European customers in different industries and business sizes using our solutions. And we're very proud that many of you are here today. We see that our customers use this in three main areas. And the first one is data analysis, where you can look at data in a free mode, so to speak, and from all angles and combination, and drill down to the level of detail that you want to see. The second main use of area, perhaps the most used, is dashboard and displays. And this is the one used on a daily basis to see if everything is going according to plan in your area, since the dashboards are role-based. If everything is as expected, you keep going. But if not, you can also, from here, drill down to see the details and take action both in good and on bad news. Many of our customers are also using Business Analyze on office screens to keep everybody up to speed on important KPIs, and we also do more and more of gamification in this area, which we will cover in a later webinar. Third but not least area of use is formal reporting at the end of a period. Typically it's a month or a quarter, or it could be a week. It's easy to produce since they can be predefined and ensures consistency both in form and source data used. We are now proud that we can offer a fully fledged cloud analytics solution, and we call it the Business Analyze Cloud. Our excellent R&D department has now released the data connector, which is an extremely important piece to the puzzle. This means that we can connect the data to other cloud solutions, and you can also use data directly from systems you have on-premise. We can also combine data from different data sources and show them in the same visualization. And combination of data from CRM and ERP is, of course, today's main topic. And we're going to show it how it works in a minute. Important to notice also, please note that you can use Business Analyze Cloud regardless of whether you have your SuperOffice on-premise or have started to use the new CRM Online. You know already that we use role-based desktops, of course. And from Supervised Analysts, you are familiar with the role-based desktops called Top Manager, Sales Manager, and so on. But going forward, you will have access to a lot of new content in the cloud, and together with new functionality in the platform, this would be a good time to look into your desktops and perhaps add and combine dashboards from different data sources, together with your partner and or us. An emerging trend is also to give external channels access to relevant dashboards and reports. Partners, sales partners, channels, customers, and the closer relationships with suppliers are example of the latter. Because we can ensure within Business Analytics Cloud that they only see what you want them to see. Many of you have already started to use cloud-based solutions. Gartner, which is one of the most trusted ICT research and advisor companies, states that by 2020, at least a no-cloud policy will be almost extinct. And we think that Business Analytics will be a nice way to start moving up to the cloud if you're not already there. Visma Software was one of the first beta partners on our cloud solution. And thanks to their passion and expertise, many improvements to product usability, security, and reliability were identified early and implemented. Visma launched a new platform internally, and they did so in February, March this year. And there are currently more than 180 people working with sales, account management, service and support using the solution. And more users and applications are planned within Visma Software and other Visma companies. This picture is this is the CEO of Visma Software in Norway, Erlend Sogn, and two of his sales managers introducing and showing off, can I say that, their internal business analysis in front of all their partners in the partner summit here in Norway. That was the introduction. Let's see on the dashboards that are supporting this day's main topics. So I'll just run off the. And here we are. This is a dashboard that will be available for everyone using this cloud solution. And what we are looking at here. So start in the left hand corner, and everybody has a target to meet for the period you are in or entering into, the period being a month, a quarter, it's up to you. And this target is stated here in the red column as the budget. For many of you, the case is that you are not entering all your sales into SuperOffice. You also have a lot of sales going directly into the ERP system or coming from web shops or coming from recurring revenue that's already invoiced and so on. So you don't get the full picture if you just look at the data you have entered into SuperOffice. So in order to get the full overview, we suggest that you also include this column here. And this data is collected from the ERP system, from the invoice system. And the solution I'm running right now is using two data sources. One is SuperOffice CRM Online, and the other one is Visma Business, which is one of the biggest ERP system in Northern Europe, actually. But it doesn't have to be exactly that ERP system. It could be any almost ERP system. So here I can see I have a target on 5.5 million for this period. I've already, thank God, invoiced over 3 million. And if I want to see the actual invoices, I also can press this one to drill down and look at the invoices underneath. We have anonymized this, so it's just say customer number down here, so we don't want to hang out anyone. The next step, so this is in the bag. What we can see on top of this is order or sold or contract signed in the CRM system. It could also be showing order intake in the ERP system, of course. And this is, so I see, but I still lack almost 1 million to reach my budget for this period. So we also have to look into the pipeline. And there I see, okay, if everything goes well in the pipeline, I could get this done with the flying colors. But is it really so? We have to dig into and see what's inside the pipeline. And this is, of course, what we see on this side. Pipeline management has been there for quite some time, and it has mostly been for the sales department. But what we see now with the introduction of the Buyer 2.0 scenario, that the marketing department also has a major impact, not just of filling up the pipeline, but throughout the pipeline. We'll get into that, but that's why I'll show you. This is the phases. That's inside the SuperOffice database that I'm running against. But and this is a typical one, because it starts with MQL, which stands for Market Qualified Lead. This is the first step. Often we see a sales accepted lead as the next one. And the third one is a typical sales qualified lead stage in the pipeline. And after that, the more traditional stages appear, which is you have demonstrated the solution, you have united on the solution per scope, running trials and so on. And the next one here in this database is you have given the customer a proposal, and that's the pipeline. You can also, from a marketing perspective, want to see perhaps how many customers has visited your web pages, which could be collected directly from Google Analytics or somewhat similar. So you can see the whole pipeline. But also, you want to have a... If you want to see what we can really expect from this pipeline, you also have to look into the historic. So this underneath here is showing me a typical win rate, which is, and here you can see it's a demo data, because they have a hit rate or win rate on 82%, which is rather fabulous. If someone of you out there has a similar, just let me know, so they're always hiring. So, from all the cases I've started with, we generally, or in average, get 82% of the cases. Another important metric is the average order size. And on all the orders we have gotten through this pipeline, it's a standard average order size on 205,000. And the third important metrics regarding pipeline is the lead time. And here we have a lead time of 54 days from the start on the top here and gone through it. And this is the main factors that you can do something about in order to increase production, to get better results, and also, as we do right now, to anticipate and do better forecasting, what we can expect from this pipeline. And if I know if this 54 days to get from the top to the bottom here, I know that if this was to be the 5 days left of the period, I could forget all about the early phases, early stages. So perhaps I can all just rely on what's left in the solution phase and the proposal phase. And if I put my mouse up here, I see that the amount, the total amount is 2.9, and this for solution phase is 1.4, and here is 1.5. So, but the total, I still have 3 million left in those two phases. And if I see what I miss here, I miss a million. Okay. I have three in the last two phases. I'm pretty sure that I'm going to make the quota for this period, even if the win rate should lower down to perhaps 50%. Okay, so and you can also have a business analyst state the numbers for you, so that we can and that this is also going forward. Things we will come with more and more content on that is to anticipate and automatically suggest what the forecast figures could be or be within a ranges of. Okay, if I want to see what's in here, I just press it and I can always, as you know, click and there I am directly within the SuperOffice CRM Online system. I have to, sorry. Like this. Okay. I also can see the orders that are going into this. Now I just took an example where we saw at the win rate and the lead time from top to bottom. But if you have, you want to have a really detailed view on this, we can also show the win rate or the conversion rate from face to face, going down the funnel, and you can also put the lead time in, so you can see how many days in average the cases are in each phase, and then you have a more even more accurate picture of what's going on, or could anticipate what's going to happen. Okay, and the pipeline is more important than ever before, and we come back to that. Especially since the buyer are changing, buyers are changing, and marketing get more and more impact. It's even more important than before to have a good view of what's going on in the pipeline. And we also we're going to dig deeper into this when looking at the historic pipeline later on. Okay, then we know what's going to happen. But also from the real P&L and the books, we can also, if you have recurring business that are invoiced at this day earlier this year, you can also see what are posted revenues within posted in the books already. And this is telling me how much in is posted there, and you can also see the change. The change could be measured up against the last period or the same period last year. So it's easy to see how you're doing because everyone is struggling to grow for growth. So it's easy to see that the change, this one is not looking good yet, but the period is not over. So the books are not closed for this period either. And you can and the income part is always the difficult one because the costs are very according to plan, used to be. And you can also look at the actual results and see the trend on that or compare them with the last year. So all of this gray area here is gathered directly from Visma Business, the P&L section. And then you get the full picture. All the invoicing you have been doing, but are the customers paying? That's also an important thing to measure. And this it was presented here. This is the accounts receivable in total, not due, and these are the accounts receivable that's overdue, that the customer has not paid them in time. And I guess you've already guessed it. If you press this one, you can see how the distribution is by day past due date. This is five different distribution columns. I can also put on the total number overdue. And of course, if I want to get in more detail, I press this one, I will see all the customers and what the status are. And this is actually sorted of what has most overdue, highest amount of overdue. And again, I could press even under this to see the actual invoices if I wanted to. This one is a very nice and easy overview of what's going on the payment section, but it's also takeaways from here is to you can also easily combine this information with the sales process information to ensure that no salesperson or no sales reps have started new sales processes towards the one that didn't pay the last invoices you sent them. So they can ensure that you're using your efforts in the sales department, field sales, on the right customers. Also, to use the combination between the CRM data, as in terms of sold and so on, and compare them what's actually invoiced in the ERP system, also saves you a lot of time to understand what the gap might be if the numbers are not the same in the two systems. And also that could be a very important time-consuming case for the sales staff, because many of them are getting commission on turnover. So this is obviously a thing that is to have information at your fingertips here is thing you can really benefit from. Okay, we also put in what should we call them, some mini analytics in here, just to show you how this, you can have a clear view of what's going on in different areas. And we can start with the one down here. This is, we call them a point of interest from the ERP system, or the favorite from the finance departments. Which employees, and this is employee numbers, it could be the names, but we want to anonymize this. So how many, employees are invoicing the most? It could be product groups, perhaps, which product group is the best selling at the moment, or the other way around. It could be products, it could be the best customers, and so on. So it's easy, just in the same visualization, to look at it from different angles. And we call this mini analytics. And if you want to do the full analytics, we have all own tabs for that. But we have, and we also have made the same point of interest from the CRM system. This is now showing the biggest open cases to close in the actual period. It could be, if I wanted to see this by team, I could see it not only by the open cases, but I could see it by all cases, open, closed, and sold, and so on. And I can see it from a lot of different angles. I can also, and this is one I think I should show you, because the source part is growing more and more important. Because, as we said earlier with the introduction of Wire 2.0, we want to see what kind of activities that leads to the best results. And using this source, we can see how much of this is generated directly by field sales, but what is coming through digital channels or partner channels, and what is coming from paid commercials, and so on. This could be more or less, of course, depending on your type of business. But to really see the impact of what's going on both above and inside the funnel, it's good to have a clear view on that so that you can see what you can do about it, so you can take actions early. And what we see, if you are the CEO, you can have a talk with marketing department or a manager to see, is there enough fillings in the top of the pipeline? And if you also combine that with the ERP system and see what the effort you spent in terms of money, you can see, are there a good ROI on this? You also can see what the sales department are doing and see that they have enough, both they fill up with the pipeline themselves, but also ensure that they are running it effectively through the pipeline to get to a closing. And if I was the CIO and I wanted to discuss the pipeline with both the manager from the sales department and the marketing department, I will also focus on what hit rate you have, because of, at the end of the sales process, it's not just sales responsibility to close the deal and win it. This must be a topic for both marketing and sales, and that this is the thing they should work on together to increase the win rate. If you get 82%, I don't know, but if you have removed this percent by percent, it will have a major impact in your growth strategy. Okay, that I think was giving you information at your fingertips, and it's easy to drill down to see what's lying underneath, and it's easy to see, am I going to meet my quota, or meet my target or not, so that I can take action early. They also said that we wanted to show you historic pipeline. I guess this has timed out by now, but we can, I'll just see if I can press it. Yeah, I have to log in again, I guess. There we go. This is not the view many of you have seen before, from at least not from SuperOffice. This is actually showing you how your pipeline looked like at any point in time. And this is looking, usually when we look at the pipeline, we look forward in time. But this is the historic edition of your pipeline, telling you how did it look like every month from the moment you are in and backwards. And you can look at it as long back as you want to, as the other business analyst reports works. And here you can have a good overview and see, okay, if we started to do more marketing activities, if we started to do more sales efforts, did the pipeline grow at this stage? Here you can easily see the bird perspective of that. And I can see that we started in this demo company to make some effort from September on. And you see it has grown substantially, and this is the amount in million, no, sorry, thousands. So it's 27 millions. And this is also a good thing to introduce to when you start using the CRM system, so that you can see that the sales process are in use. And if you have if you don't use the pipeline by now, this is also a good way to show the effort rather the effect of starting to use it. Okay, pipeline is has been for the sales department. But as we say, now it has a major impact for the whole company. But it's sometimes difficult to explain what's really going on. We said, oh, we had a lot of things going on and cooking, but what really happened in October? We had a pipeline of 11 million, but what's lying beneath here? And this is what happened in the October. We entered October with 3 million in existing cases. We got new cases for 10 million. We won 5.7 million. That's also deducted from the total pipeline. And we lost as many, That's 5.7 million as well. But when we went out of the October into November, we had the pipeline on 11.5 million. What we not did not show here, it was the changes of the amount on the existing cases. That is the difference between this as well. But this is actually, I can tell you what was going on, what went on. You started with this much, you ended up with this much, and what happened in between. This is the way it's tightening the gap. And it's a very nice way of telling also people that don't know what the pipeline is in detail, what really went on. This could also be used in the boardroom. Another takeaway from this could actually be, because you can always drill down here, down to the very details. But I have another viewing of this, because we all want to have an effective sales meeting. This is not the best design I've done so far, but it's, I will show you the benefits. Because when you have a sales meeting, very often we use too much time talking about the cases that we also talked about the last time. So many want only to focus on what has changed since the last meeting, so that we can go on and solve the difficulties and the challenges we have on ongoing cases and discuss the solutions to them instead for using time on statistics. So what I've tried to show here, that I have sorted all changes that has been made in the sales processes since the last meeting. So all those less than 7 days ago has been changed are green here. So this is actually just the cases that has altered the last days by, we show the current status of the cases, we can sort them by sales rep, of course. And if I want to see this, Toyota Norge, for instance, I just press this. And what I'm now seeing, here I can see all the updates. This is hidden information in SuperOffice, actually. But it's lying there, because it's a database underneath. And this case has been changed 3 times on these occasions. I can see what has been done. First time, it was opened, done some more with it, and it was put to rest, so to speak, at the 11th, or rather the 14th. Sorry, the 14th there of November. What we typically see is a much longer list, especially on this case was closed, and that's a good thing actually. It's better to close it early or use a lot of effort into it and close it long after it really should have been closed. I could use this to show my example, because very often we see these are all the updates on the case, and when it's not starting just to change stages to go towards the order, it's realized in the same, it's keep you being in the same phase, but suddenly only the sale date are changed. And the sale dates are changed and changed and changed, and if you have changed the sale date 5 times and nothing else, perhaps that should tell you something. Better to say, okay, enough is enough, put it to rest and go on with other cases that you have hope on getting. So this is very interesting information, both for yourself as a sales rep, but also a way of, okay, just focusing on the alterations since the last meeting. It could be a way of doing that. I just think, I hope I could find just some a little longer since, but so this is a case where it had been a lot of alterations and updates. So you see we have full track of what's going on also beneath the surface. Okay. Enough of this, but we also use the same information from here to show you how many days they have been lying in each phase and what are the conversion rates from each phase to the next. As I said, Buyer 2.0 and the new way people are making business these days has also an impact, of course, on the funnel. And earlier on, there has been this kind of deviation between marketing and sales, but as you can see, the marketing is going much further down the pipeline now than ever before. And that was the phases that we stated in the example also, was trying to show you. Okay, then we are come to the question and answer session, and we'll look and see what has come in on questions. There's this question here stating which ERP solutions can be connected. What I tried to say earlier was that the visualizations are within the platform, so that they are available at no extra cost. And but what you will have to have help from consultants to is to connect it to your ERP system. Visma Business, for instance, which I was showing today, if you are running exactly the same Visma Business as we do, you can use it right out of the box. But if you have a slightly different version, you just have your partner help you to set it up, or we could get a partner on that could help you set it up. And it's not we have not been in a situation where we were able to put data out of an ERP system. So, and we have done a lot of different ERP systems, all Visma family, Visma Global, Visma Mammut, and so on, and we've done a lot of times. And we also have done, I know we have customers running Navision and other ERP systems. Are there more questions? Yeah. What is the cost of the migration from on-premise to cloud for existing customers of Business Analyze? On the SuperOffice Analyze pages. Is this in English? Put it in English like this. Here's the pricing of the. This is the business pricing. User pricing is 1490 NOX. I could pay this, perhaps take it in euros today. 179 euros per company per month, and 23 euros per user. And but because you that are with us today are existing customers, we have another, and we urge you to talk to your partner, or just let us know, so we will get in contact with your partner, so you have exact pricing for you to migrate to the cloud, which also will contain necessary moving of tailored solutions. I think it's the best way. But we, I will say that we will have the best prices up here for our existing customers. It's not the case that new customers get the best deals. I don't like that myself. So we will give you the best prices. So it's not necessarily the ones you see here. We also have a question if this webinar will come online, and yes, we will publish. We have been recording this, I guess. Yes, they are nodding beside me here, so I think that will be the case, yes. More questions? Okay, just a short summary then. We still, of course, support our on-premise solution, and will continue to do so for the years to come. But if you want to get to the cloud, I think Business Analyze Cloud is a good way to start if you are not already there, because it's very easy, it's a low risk travel to the cloud, and you will always run the latest version. And because we have an online first when it comes to development, you always get a new functionality, and it's easier to digest it also, because we update the cloud solutions once a month, and then you can focus on the few issues, the few functionality or contents that are available to you in the new version, and digest it and start to use it and get the benefits from it. It also opens up that we can give you assist directly inside the solution, and we also, both from us and the partners, you can benefit from standard integrations that combine data from other data sources with your CRM data directly. And as you saw now, because the dashboard that I've shown you today, that they are already available in the clouds. But you can talk to us or to your partner directly to get it on top of your solution. And since there are many things to choose from, it's also making it quickly to adapt to changing needs and ensure relevancy by choosing from the continuously growing number of analytics that will be available to you. And last but not least, it will be very easy to try out new stuff before implementing it for the rest of the organization. I also got a follow-up questions where the online webinar will be put, but we will send the links to all you attending this webinar so that you can use that to get to the recording. But please remember that you can use Business Analyze Cloud as of now if you use CRM Online or if you have your SuperOffice on-premise. You could start getting benefits from the BA Cloud as of now. For those of you that already has SuperOffice CRM Online, you can get the free trial just by going into the website, our website, and start it. For those of you who still has SuperOffice on-premise, we can also arrange a trial for you, but we have to have a consultant to set up the connection, and we cannot give away our partner's time, so you have to pay a couple of hours to do that setting, but you will also be able to have a free trial even if you're running on-premise version of SuperOffice. Then, with the words of William Deming, "In God we trust, all others must bring data," I say thank you for being with us today, and have a nice one. Thank you very much.